everyone, welcome to another episode of Power Questions with Archana. Today I'm taking a question that has come to me from Denver, USA. This is Lisa Jackson, who has tagged me in one of her posts on LinkedIn. She has tagged only three people, and one, of course, is myself. She's an author, speaker, trainer, and a consultant. You must check out her profile on LinkedIn, as I will be tagging her in this episode of Power Questions with Archana. Now, her question is, Archana, what practices are you using to strengthen your team collaboration? Dear Lisa, thanks a lot for tagging me in your post, and this goes out especially for you. You know what? I feel this is quite an everyday affair. There has to be a constant reminder, the kind of leadership you exhibit for your team to know what team collaboration is all about. So here are a few pointers to help you know my style of making this possible. Point number one, communication. Communication is a collaboration enabler. Open discussions and clear communication with your team sets the mood for the ideas to flow. And where there are ideas, collaboration takes the center stage. Point number two, it starts with embracing diversity and including unique skill sets of the team to meet unified organizational goals. Now that's promoting collaboration. Point number three, letting your team know that every individual is an important part of the big picture. Now to bring that big picture to life, each individual needs to work in perfect tuning with the other, and now that's collaboration. Point number four, suggesting how someone else's idea in the team can uplift your ideas and suggestions. It's a good way to help teams know that common goals are better achieved when everyone contributes to that goal. Point number five, allow teams to take decisions and let them work on an autonomous mode. Point number six, reward them for being a team player. Point number seven, performance audits are really important and they help a great deal in understanding how collaborating with diverse teams help. Point number eight, keep your teams connected and aligned to company's goals, missions, and values. There is definitely no harm in repeating messages being sent out to them, to your team, about what is expected out of them. Point number nine, collaboration happens when you allow your teams to make mistakes. It's absolutely okay to fall. Everything is repairable. All you need is the right direction and a great strategy. Teams stay together when they're allowed to take those well-calculated risks. Point number 10, respecting everyone's skill sets and expertise gives the right direction to the team and the flow of the project is absolutely flawless. Point number 11, clear guidelines on the finishing date of the project. Now, this is a very important factor to foster team collaboration. When everyone in the team knows how important each deadline is, they make sure they stay together to accomplish that goal. Point number 12, lead by example, very important. Expecting your team to follow the mission, vision, and the goals of the organization only comes when they see you exhibiting these qualities. Be the role model for your team. Humble, empathetic, respecting others for their time. Help them meet deadlines. Stay open to ideas and change. So these are a few points that I follow to bring in collaboration within my teams. I hope you really enjoyed listening to this. Please keep writing into me on the email ID given below, and I will be happy to answer all your queries. I hope you really enjoyed.